You're watching our NDTV exclusive. There's been another big twist in the ongoing Pegasus scandal, where for the first time, a government, in this case the French government, has actually confirmed the infection of Pegasus. In the case of two journalists in France, these journalists belong to the French investigative site Mediapart, which is known here as one of the primary media portals that investigated the Rafale scam. And I'm actually joined by Edwy Plenel, who's one of the editors at Mediapart, one of whose phone was found to be infected. Edwy, thank you very much for talking to us on NDTV. This is quite a big development so far, because at the moment it's really been the Amnesty Lab which has confirmed the infection of phones with Pegasus. But now you actually have a government that has confirmed that infection, including your own phone. Edwy, tell us how it came about.
It's a big event in this investigation. As Mediapart, we complain to the public prosecutor the day of the revelations by Forbidden Stories and the Amnesty Lab. And yesterday, it was an audition by the French police. Mm-hmm. And during this audition, the technical expertise of the French administration confirmed the infections of our phones, my phone and one journalist, Lénaïc Brodou, Mediapart journalist. Our two phones were really infected by the spyware Pegasus, sold by this Israeli company NSO Group. It's a big event because we were sure with Amnesty and Forbidden. Their verification, they made it in Berlin with a technical lab, but also in Toronto at the Canada with the Citizen Lab. Mm-hmm. But now it's another verification, official verification in a judicial suite in with the police, French police, on the documents it's written now, and that's a big event, because we hope that the justice will make all the truth about this story.
Right.
It's a big scandal, and you know that in India,
yes,
more than 40 journalists were spied by Pegasus. And you know, as Snowden, Edward Snowden said, inaction is no longer an option.
Right.
We must reclaim a total ban of all kinds of spyware and companies making it, because it's a threat,
okay,
for all democracy.
Yeah, for all democracies. But so just to understand, basically in France, as you pointed out, the public prosecutor has opened an investigation into Pegasus, which is, I think, one of the only countries where that's happening. And as part of that, you were summoned, you and I believe your other colleagues, and you were asked if you were to submit your phone to the French Cybersecurity Agency. I think the acronym is ANSSI. And essentially, they did what? They basically, Edwy, asked you to submit the data of your phone, or you had to submit your phone itself to this agency?
There was a sort of a procedure, because this is my new phone.
Ah, but, okay.
what they are doing?
Right.
I keep the old phone.
Okay.
At the date of when we with Amnesty and Forbidden, we were sure of the infection, and I don't touch to this phone, and I give the phone to the technical expertise of the French administration.
Right.
But with the sort of a protocol, with they don't touch to my personal files.
Right.
They only go to the technical.
Okay.
They can saw this Pegasus virus.
I was going to ask you that, because as an investigative journalist, you would not otherwise want to give your phone to the government. But it's only the technical, not the personal.
Exactly.
Just a few questions for you. One is, were they able to tell you when your phone was infected? And two, was there any hint about the source of the infection? Who was it that may be behind it?
They confirm exactly what Amnesty Lab discovered. The date, it was for me in 2019, during 2 months, mm-hmm. to the 5th of July and the 5th of September. For my colleague, Lenaïc Bredoux, it was during one year and a half, 2020, and they confirm exactly the date. They confirm also the process. Mm. The virus arrived notably by a sort of gate. That is the iMessage in the iPhone. You don't. There is no indication. It's totally silent. With no, but they leave some
traces behind.
Traces.
Which is how you found it. Edwy, tell me, because media part. I mean, I'm sure you do a lot of investigative work, but yes. We here in India know you for your work on Rafal. Is that something that could be a possibility, that because of the Rafale work you may have been targeted?
In this case, no. It was really the state, the rogue state, because it's a very, very bad manners, no democratic manners, was Morocco. It was not India. It was Morocco. We make investigation about human rights in Morocco, about torture also, about all the police and authoritarian state of this monarchy, and we can prove that because the same traces to my phone and phone of Moroccan journalists. Our partner, like partners in India, like The Wire, it was the same technology, the same traces, and now these journalists in Morocco, they are in jail for years.
Oh, I see. Okay.
4 years.
So it's your investigative work you did in Morocco,
yes.
which you think is likely to have got you targeted,
exactly.
likely by
exactly.
the Moroccan government. Okay.
Exactly. But there is a big question. When this company, NSO Group, sells this virus, this spyware to rogue states, who have all the what they find? The Israeli company can have all this information also?
Yes.
The Israeli government? But more of that, Morocco is really linked to the French government.
I see.
Can
so it could
be
even
sure
be. I
that
see.
They don't sell or offers
sure.
all what they find on my phone to the French government. I don't know.
Okay.
That's the
so
reason
it's, right.
they ask the justice.
No. That's a legitimate fear that once the data is in the hands of a private operator, then it could be going. Anyway, so there are serious questions. Let's see how this story plays itself out. But yes, this was a big twist in the Pegasus scandal, with the government now finding proof of the confirmation of the infection of the spyware. Thank you very much indeed, Edwy Plenel of Media Park, for speaking to us.
Bye-bye.